Coors Field in Denver. A good matchup here for you tonight between the Chicago Cubs and the Colorado Rockies. Major League Baseball on the show
and
is
now,
next.
Your 2021 Colorado Rockies.
Kyle Freeland, the native of Colorado, gets the start on the mound. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Well, this guy's kind of unique. How about a five-pitch repertoire that he has that gives him a lot of options for both righties and lefties? And if he's on, he could be really tough to hit.
Ready now is number 66. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. The 1-1. Not a bad night to bring the parka along. 54 degrees at game time. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. And that'll get down out there for extra bases. And this'll bang up against the wall. And he will coast into second with a leadoff double.
Now that is the way you want to start a game on the road. He comes out swinging and stands at second as the first base runner of the night. Now we'll see if his teammates can pick him up and if they can punch first.
At the plate now, Sergio Alcantara. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two.
He's gone to the well with that pitch three times in a row. I'm interested to see if he changes it up right here.
And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
In now, Wilson Contreras. And he comes back with one down and in for ball three.
You would think in this situation, maybe with a base open, he'd just pitch around him and put him on first. But not with the guy in the on-deck circle. He's going to attack this hitter.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Now a changeup just off the plate as that misses for ball four.
I'm sure the manager is fine with that. He tried to entice him with that 3-2 pitch, but he didn't take the bait. First base was open, though, so he just needs to make a good pitch for a ground ball.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Patrick Wisdom. Great chance to drive in a run here in the early going. The 1-1 home is a changeup that's looked at for a ball.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot he's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
He takes the changeup the other way out toward right center. Blackman on the move. He gets there, and that's the second out.
That is it. The right fielder, Jason Hayward.
So it's first and second with two men gone, and that'll bring up the multi-gold glover, Jason Hayward. Here's the 1-1. Fouled off. And another foul ball. Here's the 1-2. In the dirt here. And a nice job to keep the runners at bay as the count moves to 2-2. And that misses there, so he runs the count full now.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Hayward takes as that pitch misses for ball four. He'll take the walk.
At this rate, he's going to set some kind of a record for walks issued in a game, or he'll get an early hook. We'll see if he can settle down here and start to find the strike zone, or if he continues to struggle.
So in now for Chicago, Ian Happ, lifetime in this matchup. He's 1-for-3. Ready with the 1-1. 1-2 as the changeup had him out in front there.
Definitely a big pitch coming up right here. He's going to be pumped if he can work his way out of this inning with the game still tied.
From the stretch, the 1-2. And he missed with it up and in to even things at 2-2. Now this is on the ground to second. Is he going to get out of this? He is. They get the force at second base, and the inning is over. A couple of walks, but no damage. It's on to the bottom of the first. No score on the show. Zach Davies, a Washington-born right-hander, gets the starting assignment. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, it's hard to have all four of your pitches on, but I think if this guy can have two or three of his four pitches and have command of them, he's going to have a really good game.
And now, Raimel Tapia. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Hit to first, fielded cleanly, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out.
Batting second, the second baseman, Rendon Rogers.
So one down, no one aboard, and that'll bring up Brendan Rogers. Looked like the cut fastball there, and he got him to swing through it for the second out.
Batting third.
Here's Charlie Blackman
right
now. Head-to-head numbers
Charlie
against Zach Davies.
Blackman.
He's got three base hits in 18 at-bats. He's also gone down on strikes five times. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Two out, nobody on. Swing and a line drive. And a little self-preservation down at first as he pulls that one in to end the inning. Three up, three down for Colorado. And this is still a nothing-nothing ball game. Now into the box, Matt Duffy. He'll get us started in the top of the second. Hit out towards second. Rogers brings it in. Throw in time at first. A nice play in short right for the first out.
Batting it. The second baseman, David Bodie.
The next Cub up, David Bodie. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. That's low, ball four.
Well, he's really laboring in the early going here. That's his third walk of the game already. We'll see if he can get it together or if this is just one of those days where he's going to have to grind his way through this start.
And now the Cubs pitcher, Zach Davies. He could be bunting here in order to stay out of the double play. The 1-1. Now a bunt attempt here. Only play to the pitcher covering, and the runner moves into second on the play. So now here is number 66 looking to put them ahead early with this at bat. The set and the 1-1. Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2.
You see that so much left on left matchup. that slider down in a way that you get a bad swing on it. There's so many few left-handed hitters that are willing to drive the ball up the middle the other way.
Even count, two balls and two strikes. Just the second inning, but already 37 pitches to this point. Sent on the ground out to second. Rogers picks it up. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Cubs strand one. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Striding in for the Rockies, Trevor Story. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. Weak grounder back to the mound. And a good throw gets him, one gone.
Batting fifth, the third baseman, Ryan McMahon.
Here's Ryan McMahon now. Head-to-head numbers against Zach Davies. He's 0 for 7. And he fouls this one off. Ready on 1-2. Base hit, line drive into the corner. He's through first and hustling for second. And he is in at second base with a one-out double.
As we take another look here, you can see it's a two-seam fastball running away from him at the plate. So he does the smart thing, not trying to pull it or just rolling over it, just goes with it and has enough juice on it to drive it for a double.
Standing in now, C.J. Cron hit softly on the ground to third, and there are two away now. So a runner in scoring position with two men gone. Now digging in will be Sam Hilliard.
Hilliard.
McMahon stands at second with two gone. One and two now as that one's fouled off. One and two, here it is. Again, he sends it out of play. Ready with the 1-2. Swing and a miss. He struck him out with a two-seamer, and the inning is over. The love of the game runs deep with these folks. Two complete. Still scoreless here on the show. Now it'll be Sergio Alcantara, struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch outs will stick with you a little longer.
Lifted in the air out towards left center. Center fielder giving chase. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning.
The catcher.
Stepping up is Wilson Contreras, worked a walk in his first plate appearance. The 1-1 home.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence, he's got great body language on the mound, he's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
Rolled slowly down the third baseline. Throw just in time, and oh, that was awfully close.
Now
the Cubs' four-hole hitter, Patrick Wisdom, fly down in his first at-bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far. Hit well towards the hole, and this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single.
Up next for the Cubs, the right fielder, Jason Hayward.
To the plate now, Jason Hayward. And this one's in the dirt, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. Working for the punch out and the offering. Flipped out the other way towards short. Throw to second for the force out, and the side is retired. One left for the Cubs. Home half of the third coming up. No score. Bottom of the inning now, and now it'll be the catcher, Dom Nunez. Skied into straightaway right. Hayward has a read on it, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning.
Batting
so
nine.
Here now is the pitcher, Kyle Freeland.
Kyle Freeland.
Rockies pitcher with a bat in his hands and a 1-2 count.
Wow, great pitch right there, right? Changing speeds. How about that straight changeup? How about that swing? Howdy, if you're waving at me.
And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. Sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
Had to wait back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. The next 3-2. Late on that one as it's fouled off to the left side. And he finally wins the battle as this is swung on and missed for the second out.
Now, I know he struck out there, but for a pitcher, that's a
now
pretty solid at bat. Anytime you can make an opposing pitcher out there work and throw a few more extra pitches, that's a quality AB in my book.
Into the box, Raimel Tapia. 1-2 now.
One ball, two strikes.
Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup.
When a pitcher puts you in the proverbial rocking chair like he's doing right now, you have to take a deep breath. You can't start trying to guess along with him. Trust you.
Well, the left fielder's on it, and that retires the side. 1-2-3 go the Rockies. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. All set for the start of the inning, and that'll bring up the former first rounder and Pittsburgh area native Ian Happ.
The old adage, pitching and defense have been stellar so far. They've certainly kept both offenses in check.
And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin stanza number four.
Well, they haven't been able to scratch a run across yet, so maybe this walk will jumpstart their offense a little bit.
So here is Matt Duffy. Broken bat as this ball's hit on the ground. He's got it. And he'll just step on first here to take the sure out.
And you know, guys, if this bat doesn't break, it's probably a double play ball, but that just wasn't happening here. Good job to make sure of one, though.
So now to the plate, David Bote. Stung into the gap in right center for what should be extra bases. Yankees in at second safely as they jump ahead with a run scoring on the play.
The pitcher was spotting his pitches effectively until now, working the edges, painting the corners, but he left this one right over the plate, and it cost him with an RBI extra base hit right there.
At the plate now, Zach Davies. Cubs pitcher at the plate trailing with a 1-2 count.
Hey, he's got great feel for that pitch right there. He can throw it anytime he wants for a strike.
Hit on the ground down the first baseline. Scooped up, and he'll take this one to the bag for the out. But meanwhile, the runner will move up 90 feet to third base.
Now batting. Number
66.
Now
back to the leadoff spot in the Cubs lineup. Stepping forward, number 66. 1-for-2 with a double on his line thus far. Modi on third with two out. Inside, he misses ball four.
And things are not looking good here in the fourth inning. That's the second walk of the frame. Good time for the catcher to go out to the mound and have a chat with this guy to give him a little breather.
So next to hit is Sergio Alcantara. Two men on, two away here in the fourth. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Tapia is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. But a run will score in the inning on this RBI double. Bottom of the fourth coming up. It's now 1-0 Chicago. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And standing in is the power-hitting second baseman, Brendan Rodgers. Three and one, here it is. Hit out toward second. Fielded cleanly. And that's out number one. And that'll bring in Charlie Blackman. Hit it hard, but lined out in his first at bat.
Yeah, pretty unlucky right there, Matty. Squared up a fastball nicely, and that's all you can do. You just want to be on time for the heater, and he's prepared for this next AB.
Ball taken there. 2-1 now. Into the windup and the pitch. And it's fouled away.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
And that's the second out.
Now batting.
Trevor Story steps in now. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Bounce to first, reined in, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. So they breeze through this half of the inning. On to the top of inning number five we go. The Cubbies are in front, 1-0. All ready to go in the top of the fifth, and next the dangerous power threat, Wilson Contreras. And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1. And that Colorado bullpen comes to life now with a lefty and a right-hander up to throw. The 2-1 home.
This is where you cash your checks right here. 3-1. You're one of the best hitters in the game. You live for situations like this.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Down the right field line. That's a fair ball. Around first. He's digging for second. And the Cubs could be onto something here. It's a leadoff double. Well, it's always daunting to know that you've got to deal with the 3, 4, 5 hitters to start out an inning, but even more so when the 3 hitter starts it out with a double.
Yeah, he's going to have to start making some good pitches to get out of this thing. Job number one is to get the next guy, and ideally, you keep him from advancing the runner to third with less than 2 outs.
In now, Patrick Wisdom. And they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
Oh, I love that pitch right there. Up and in, jam sandwich.
Now a swing, and he gets him to pop it up, and this is going to wind up a foul ball. Contreras leads off second with nobody out. Lays off the 1-2 changeup, and he's worked it back to 2-2. Into center field, line drive base hit. The runner from second crosses the plate. It's a 2-0 ball game.
That's what we refer to in the biz as a hanger right there. He's lucky he's getting his baseball back.
Into the box now, Jason Hayward. That nibbled the corner there, but missed 2-1.
Sitting in a good spot right here. 2-1 count is yet to see a fastball. Have to be sitting on one right here.
2 runs, 5 hits. No errors so far for the Cubbies. The count now at 2-2. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
That was some nice execution on that pitch. Spotted it nicely down around the bottom of the zone. And when you do that, especially with 2 strikes, not a lot of guys are going to hurt you. You're going to get a lot of ground balls and swings and misses down there.
Here comes manager Bud Black out of the dugout heading for the mound. And a change is forthcoming as that's going to do it for his starter here this evening. So he'll make his way to the dugout after working just 4 1/3, and he just didn't have his best stuff in this one. Jose Mujica enters to make an appearance on the mound as he inherits a runner at first with 1 out in the inning.
Mujica.
Stepping in now, Ian Happ. High in the air out to center field. Hilliard is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first.
The third base.
Next to dig in, Matt Duffy. 0-for-2 for him to this point. Now the 2-1 pitch.
Down to 3-1.
3-2, 2 out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball 4.
Well, when you go with the slider there in a full count, you're hoping that the hitter is thinking fastball and swings through it. Didn't work out that way, though. He lays off and gets the free pass.
Stepping in once again is David Bodie. He doubled his last time up.
And he's got to build off that last AB. He battled. Usually when you battle, you get in that swing mode. A lot of pitches, you'll swing at the rosin bag. I love the fact that he was able to work a double in last at bat. Let's see if we get more of the same right here.
After it is Blackman, but he's not going to get this one. It's into the gap. And the second run will score. It's now a 4-0 game.
He's been making it look real easy out there. Two at bats, two doubles. They might want to think about pitching around him the next time he steps in, because he looks locked in for this one.
Into the box, Zach Davies. One ball and two strikes to count.
Hey, I know it's the pitcher at the plate, but he's going to grind it out right here. He's got a chance to help himself, and nothing's a bigger backbreaker to a team than watching the pitcher drive in a run.
Here comes the 1-2. Down the third baseline, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Has a look, now the pitch. And that misses 2-2. Three runs already home here. And he strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as this side is retired. So three runs on three hits, no errors, and a man left. Home half of the fifth coming up. It's the Cubs 4 and the Rockies nothing. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Rockies skipper Bud Black between innings, specifically about his club's offensive output to this point.
And he was pretty blunt in saying they're just not having very good at-bats. They've only managed one base runner in this game, so it's easy to see why he said they haven't shown much fight today. He's hoping to see someone step up and find a way to get something going, though. This game isn't out of hand, so it remains to be seen if they can snap out of this funk and climb back into this one.
Thank you, Heidi. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and Ryan McMahon digs in to bat next. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Happ is under this one. One down. Here's C.J. Crone now. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Fouled away. He'll try again, 1-2. Hit down the line at first. And this is going to be a foul ball. No runs, just one hit. No errors in the ballgame for the Rockies thus far. Drilled down the line. And that gets through for a one-out base hit. So only the second hit he's given up tonight.
Yeah, man, he's locked in and pretty dominant since the first. So as long as he can get back in that groove with the next batter, he's not going to worry too much about it.
The batter will be Sam Hilliard. Comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. Never tempted to swing at that ball down low. It's ball three.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
And a great location that time on the corner. 3-2 now.
One of the best ways to keep a guy uncomfortable is to pound him inside. They're doing that, and this one caught the zone.
Looking to punch him out again. The pitch. Fastball. Strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing in that location. So a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
To the plate now, Dom Nunez. And that one misses badly. It's ball two. Crone, the runner at first with two gone. Two and two to the Colorado catcher. Hey. fastball well outside.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
From the belt, kicks and deals. Nope. And this pitch misses for ball four. So that's going to move a runner into scoring position now with two away.
Oh, man, I think this walk is going to grind at him for a bit.
Pitcher.
He just missed, and now the inning continues with the man in scoring position.
Number nine will start to loosen up in the on-deck circle as he'll bat with two on and two out here.
Number nine.
The 3-1. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Long run for the left fielder. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. Two left for Colorado. They're on the short end of a 4-0 score. Antonio Santos takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
Number 46, Antonio Santos.
Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, number 66. 1-for-2 with a double on the ledger so far. The 1-1 home is laid off for ball two. To 2-2 now. Just hung in there on that one. The 2-2 one more time. Grounded up the first baseline. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out.
The batter.
Now at the plate, Sergio Alcantara. He could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch.
Two balls, one strike.
One out, nobody on. On, he pops it up. McMahon into foul territory, and that's going to land foul.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
Tapia comes on now and puts it away for the second out of the inning.
Now batting.
Next to hit will be Wilson Contreras. He came across to score after doubling in his last at bat.
Yeah, he did a great job to go down and get that one his last at bat. But I got to think they're going to pitch him up, maybe elevate something in the zone. Interested to see how he approaches this next AB.
2-2 to the Cubs catcher. Here now the 2-2. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue.
Hey, last two pitches back-to-back, off-speed, then he's late on the fastball. He could pretty much do anything he wants right here on the mound.
And a slider swung on and missed, and the side is retired. Three up, three down for the Cubs. But they're in front, 4-0. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and digging in is the outfielder, Raimel Tapia. Here comes the 1-2. Grounded slowly to the left side. He's right there. Off balance throw, but he couldn't get enough on it, so it'll be scored as an infield single.
Now batting.
I know that has to be frustrating from a pitcher's standpoint, but nice execution, nice hustle. Bottom line, nice hustle. Pitcher still one good pitch away from getting a double play.
You know, D-Row, one of the things you want to do is make quality pitches as a pitcher, and there's not much you can do right there. You make a pretty good pitch, and the next thing you know, you have a leadoff single on an infield ground ball.
At the plate, Brendan Rodgers. That nibbled the corner there, but missed 2-1.
Got to believe the pitcher's going to trust his defense right here. Look for something down in his zone to induce a ground ball double play.
Tapia on at first, nobody out. And he misses again, ball three.
We all know this guy is a great hitter. In a 3-1 count, this is just what he's looking for. He loves to hit when the count's in his favor like this.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Hit in the air down the right field line. And this will wind up a foul ball. Once again, a 3-2. Swing, and he takes this the other way to right. But this is right at him in right field as he hardly has to move to take it in for the first out.
Now batting, the right fielder, Charlie.
In now for Colorado, Charlie Blackman. He bounced out last time up.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result. That's his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
And that misses, 2-1. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Happ is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Trevor Story, grounded out in his last at bat.
Story.
Here comes the 1-2. Skied into straightaway right. Hayward on the run. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. One left for Colorado. They trail here 4-0. Seventh inning ready to roll, and next to bat will be the first baseman, Patrick Wisdom. The 1-1. High and deep down the left field line, and foul. This is lifted out to left. Giving chase is Tapia. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out. Here's Jason Hayward now. He was sat down on strikes in his last at bat. Bases are empty, one man out. Hit high and deep out there to left center field. Looking up is Tapia, into the bleachers and gone. A solo shot that time off the bat of Jason Hayward. And the Cubs have now opened this up to a 5-0 lead.
Yeah, and you never want to downplay a home run, but they've had runners on base all game long and couldn't get a home run in that situation. Hey, it's only a solo shot, but they'll take it. But you have to think they're feeling like they've missed some opportunities in this one.
In now, Ian Happ. And the good fastball there finds the zone as the count goes full now, 3-2.
What a well-executed fastball right there, down and away. If you're going to do any damage with that pitch, you have to think up the middle the other way, and you have to be diving and leaning out over that thing.
Boy, and he rips this ball down the left field line. But this is going to land foul, so they'll tee it up again, 3-2. In the air out to left. And he will run this one down. A good read off the bat for the second out.
The third base.
Now to bat,
five.
Matt Duffy.
Matt Duffy.
A 1-1. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two. Bases are empty here with two men out. This is flared out towards second. Oh, what a stop on the slide. In time.
Ladies and gentlemen, we enjoy the tradition.
Cubs get a run here thanks to this solo home run. Bottom of the seventh inning coming up. Get up and stretch. It's the Cubs 5 and the Rockies nothing. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Adam Morgan will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Nico Hoerner is into the ballgame as well, as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch. So now into the box is Ryan McMahon. He doubled earlier in the game, 1-for-2 to this point. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Now here's the pitch.
Ball back outside. We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
Good job going down and hanging with it that time. The 2-2 one more time. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
That swing tells me he was really trying to get a pitch out front and rip it down the line, but that wasn't a great pitch to do it on. It's really not the best two-strike approach either.
Standing in now, CJ Krohn. Keeping it down here as it's to 1-2. It looks like the Cubs will get a left-hander up and working out of the bullpen. One out, nobody on. And it's another K. So back-to-back strikeout victims to start this relief outing.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
At the plate now, Sam Hilliard. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. And indeed it will. He throws him out at first, and the side is retired. Three up, three down for Colorado. Need to get it going soon. It's 5-0. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Yuldies Chacin will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Garrett Hampson will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number nine hold in the order here on that double switch. New inning set to get underway, and that'll bring up one of the better clutch hitters on the landscape, David Bote. The 1-1 home. Smoked on the ground up the middle and into center field, a base hit. So early trouble here to start the eighth inning.
Well, Dan, the sun goes down and this guy lights up right here. That's his third knock of the night.
Talk about having a good night. Three hits, and hey, he might have another at bat or two before this one ends.
Stepping in now, Nico Hoerner. A ball and two strikes now. Now a right-hander has started to get loose in the Colorado bullpen. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one.
Boy, that's really disappointing for a guy that has wheels, right? All he wants to do is get on base and take advantage of the strength of his game, which is his speed. But with the strikeout right there, you can't get on first base if you strike out.
Into the box now, number 66. Checked his swing there, and did he go? No, he did not, says the third base umpire. Ball two. Here now the 2-2. Now this is hit not all that hard out to second. The second for one, but one's all they were ever going to get, and the inning will continue.
Took a pretty long time for the shortstop to receive the ball that time. So that gave the runner plenty of time to bear down on him and take him out. Hopefully everyone's okay down there.
At the plate, Sergio Alcantara. Fastball just missed above the zone. The 2-1 on its way. Lifted down the line and left. On the run is Tapia, and no one will track it down. Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now, 3-2.
Well, this has been a long inning already, and I know he doesn't want it to get any longer. I expect a challenge pitch right here.
3-2 pitch. Hit on the ground out to short. Story brings it in. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Cubs strand one as they're unable to add to their 5-0 lead. Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and next to hit is the catcher, Dom Nunez. Two balls and a strike, here it comes. Got him to swing under that one. It's 2-2. Cubs have someone working in their bullpen now as a right-hander's begun to get loose. Here now the 2-2.
We got 3 balls and 2 strikes.
No pitcher likes to take the count to 3-2, especially when you throw a non-competitive pitch like that on 2-2. That one wasn't even close.
Full count, here it comes. And this is taken here for ball four. So the leadoff man's on base to kick off the home eighth.
I know one thing, he earned that free pass right there. He was tempted with some really good pitches, but he stayed disciplined and drew the walk.
And that'll bring in Garrett Hampson. And he's getting his first plate appearance here in the eighth after entering off the bench just a little bit ago. Here now the 2-2. Line towards center field. And that's in there. Base hit.
Hey, this might be their best opportunity to at least get on the board. They've been struggling offensively, and they find themselves with two runners on board. Let's see if they can continue.
So the Rockies lineup turns over, and to the plate, Raimel Tapia. And his guys are looking to erase that donut on the scoreboard with a runner in scoring position.
Yeah, Matt, they've been really shut down so far in this one. They've had runners on base, but haven't been able to string anything together.
And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
It's been a really rough day for this lineup. There's really no other way to say it. Not a lot of good scoring opportunities, and when they've had them, like right now, it's just been an uphill battle for them to make anything positive happen.
In now, Brendan Rodgers. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball.
Boy, the Rockies have been looking for that big hit all game long. They haven't been able to come through so far, but now would be the time to come through.
Here comes the payoff pitch. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. Striding in is Charlie Blackman. And with men on base and two away, it feels like this at-bat could go a long way toward deciding this thing.
No doubt, Matt. A base hit here changes this game quite a bit. But if they can't score here, it looks pretty bleak for them heading into the last couple of innings.
Now the 2-1. Lifted down the line in left. Left fielder is on the move. A dive, and he brings it in. And on a fantastic play, the inning is over. One more look at the full extension catch that strands two men on the base paths. More ahead from Denver right after this. All set to start the ninth in this one, and stepping in the long ball threat, Wilson Contreras. Popped up. Story is under it. And that's the first out of the inning.
Now batting.
Into the box, Patrick Wisdom. On the night, he's 2-for-4 with a pair of singles. Bases are empty, one man out. Fastball here misses low, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Fouled off. The 2-2 one more time. Now here's another pitch fouled off and heading for the seats, and he's just fighting to stay alive here. Still 2-2. Bat explodes as this has popped up, and he'll find a way to dodge the shrapnel out there to make the play for out number two.
Now batting. The right fielder.
Now at the plate here is Jason Hayward. He's got a hit in three at bats to this point.
Yeah, Matt, and going back to that last at bat when he hit the homer, that was a fastball that was up in the zone. This guy likes the ball up in the zone, so if I'm on the mound right now, I'm thinking try to keep the ball at the knees and below. He doesn't handle that low pitch quite as well.
Now another 1-2. And there's strike three. So we'll see now if they can manage to hold on to this huge lead as the side is retired. Cubs are down in order, but they hold a 5-0 lead. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Jason Adam will come on to pitch here, and he'll move into the number 5 spot in the lineup now on the double switch. Ian Miller will also enter as a part of the double switch as he'll hit in the 7 hole in the lineup. And that brings in the power hitting shortstop Trevor Story. He's going to lead things off in their half of the ninth as they try to avoid the dreaded shutout.
It's never a good feeling to get shut out, and over the course of the season, it's bound to happen a few times. They've just been overmatched by good pitching.
Now the 2-1 pitch is a low changeup that's laid off.
And obviously this guy's a double threat up there. He can run and he can go yard too. You don't want to walk him because he might steal a base on you, but you don't want to groove a fastball either because he could take you out of the yard.
Good fastball as he gets the swing and a miss.
When you get yourself to a 3-1 count and you get a fastball, those are the ones you really want to punish. Couldn't get the bat on it, so we'll see if that comes back to haunt him.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. Out in front there as this one's pulled off to the left side. The next 3-2. Hit hard on the ground to first. And he'll step on first for the out. 3 unassisted.
The third baseman, number 24.
Next, it'll be Ryan McMahon. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat. One out, nobody on. Changeup just off the black, and it's 2-1. And now the Cubs' bullpen will start working here as both a lefty and a righty are up. Now the 2-1. Grounded sharply, but right at that loaded side of the infield. On to first, and the Rockies are now down to their final out of the game. So that'll bring up C.J. Cron. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. Two out, nobody on. Two balls and a strike to C.J. Cron. Unable to get the bat around in time, and the count evens at 2-2. Last strike now for Colorado. Way inside with that one, a pretty easy take there. And he gets strike three called to end it here, and with that, this one is over.
You might think it's just another win, but it's awfully hard to win in this game, especially on the road. But they find a way to get it done, and they should be very happy with this performance.
A 5-0 finish tonight. The Chicago Cubs took the lead in the fourth and held on until the end. Zach Davies earns the victory on the mound. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter, at MLB The Show.
Here now is the final line score tonight. First for the victorious Chicago Cubs. 5 runs, 8 hits, no errors. They left 9 runners on.